Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are keeping fine and safe. So let's start our video today. I know you all are preparing for your examination. So this is a very critical question and an important one which can appear for your questions. Just refer to this. The Rajya Sabha has certain special powers vis-a-vis the Lok Sabha that adds to its prestige. So you can understand very well since this question is relating to the Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha and its powers and prestige. So how important politically, and it will be a very important question for your examination. So let's probe into the answer. Special powers of the Rajya Sabha. As you can see, the Rajya Sabha has certain special powers against the Lok Sabha that adds to the prestige. So you have to discuss about the Rajya Sabha special powers, and you can discuss some parts of Lok Sabha also. But the Rajya Sabha has to have a super hand on this answer. So the special powers of Rajya Sabha, let's start with it. The Rajya Sabha, being a federal chamber, enjoys certain special powers under the constitution. All the subjects or areas regarding legislation have been divided into three lists that you most of you might know. That is the union list, which the center prepares, the state list, which the state prepares, and the concurrent list, which both jointly prepares. Union and state lists are mutually exclusive, as I told you. One cannot legislate on a matter placed in the sphere of the other. So the state list will be prepared completely by the state, and the union list will be prepared completely by the union. But as in case of concurrent list, both jointly will make the list, and so the decisions will be taken. However, if Rajya Sabha passes a resolution by a majority of not less than 2/3 of members present and voting, and saying that it is necessary or expedient in the national interest that Parliament should make a law on a matter enumerated in the state list, Parliament becomes empowered to make a law on the subject specified in the resolution for a whole or any part of the territory of India. Such a resolution remains in force for a maximum period of 1 year. But this period can be extended again by 1 year at a time by passing a similar resolution further. So you can understand from this paragraph itself that the superpower of Rajya Sabha is exercised here. Because if Rajya Sabha passes a resolution by its majority, that is 2/3 of the members present in the meeting and voting, saying necessary or expedient in the national interest, that is, This matter or decision will be passed for cases relating to national interest, and therefore the Rajya Sabha will take a super hand on this decision if it is passed. So this will remain in its power for a period of 1 year, and next it can be extended again by 1 year at the time of resolution or extending it further. If Rajya Sabha passes a resolution by a majority of not less than 2/3 of the members present and voting, declaring that it is necessary or expedient in the national interest to create one or more All India services common to the Union and the states, Parliament becomes empowered to create by law such services. You can understand that if Rajya Sabha is taking a resolution by majority, which I already told you again in the previous slide, of 2/3 members present and voting, that it is necessary for the national interest cause or for All India services, which can be determined as for the entire India. So then such decisions or such laws and services will be passed, where only the Rajya Sabha can be taken in a super hand. Under the constitution, the president is empowered to issue proclamation in the event of national emergency. So in case of national emergency, the president is the only person who can declare it and make proclamations, issue proclamations and take necessary decisions according to it. In the event of failure of this constitutional machinery in a state, or in case of financial emergency. So you know emergencies are of three types, that is financial emergency, national emergency, that is during the times of war, or constitutional machinery. So in these three types of emergency, that is the constitutional emergency, national emergency, and financial emergency, the president is the ultimate deciding person. Okay. So every such proclamation that the president makes has to be approved by both the houses of the parliament within a stipulated period. Actually, the stipulated period is 2 months. Under certain circumstances, however, Rajya Sabha enjoys special powers in this regard. So what is this special power? If a proclamation is issued at a time when when Lok Sabha has been dissolved or the dissolution of Lok Sabha takes place within the period allowed for its approval, then the proclamation remains effective if the resolution approving it is passed by Rajya Sabha within the period specified in the constitution as per the Article 352, 356 and 360. By this, I try to mean is during the time of emergency, when this emergency declaration is passed, in such a circumstance, both the houses will have to pass this, issue this, that is the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. But if this emergency is declared at a time when Lok Sabha is dissolved, then Rajya Sabha is the sole deciding power. But however, after things are reconstituted, Lok Sabha is reconstituted, it will have to sign it within 30 days of its reconstitution. That is, approve it within 30 days of reconstitution. But till that time, Rajya Sabha is the sole deciding power for this. Next, coming to the financial matters, including Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha, in case of financial matters, a money bill can be introduced only in the Lok Sabha. That is the power of Lok Sabha. But where is Rajya Sabha important in this? After it is passed by that house, it is transmitted to Rajya Sabha for its concurrence or recommendation. The power of Rajya Sabha in respect of such a bill is very limited. Rajya Sabha has to return such a bill to Lok Sabha within a period of 14 days from its receipt. If not returned to the Lok Sabha within that time, the bill is deemed to have been passed by both the houses at the expiration of the said period, or the mentioned period, that is the 14 days, and in the form which it was passed by the Lok Sabha, it will come into its execution. Again, Rajya Sabha cannot amend a money bill. It can only recommend amendments, and the Lok Sabha may either accept it or reject all of the recommendations made by the Rajya Sabha. So this is a position where Rajya Sabha is not taking an upper hand. For cases relating to money bill, the Lok Sabha is the only deciding power, whereas the Rajya Sabha, in case of a money bill, will be making recommendations, or amendments can be made by the Rajya Sabha, but it is to the sole discretion of Lok Sabha whether at all it will consider its recommendations or not. And if within the 14 days of the receipt of the money bill of the Lok Sabha, they do not return it with the recommendations or acceptance, then it is deemed to have been passed by the Rajya Sabha. Apart from a money bill, there are certain other categories of financial bills that can be introduced only in the Rajya Sabha. So in case of money bill, definitely Rajya Sabha does not exercise superpowers, but there are other cases of financial bills where Rajya Sabha exercises. So there are, however, some other types of financial bills on which there are no limitations on the powers of the Rajya Sabha. These bills may be initiated in any houses, that is either the Rajya Sabha or the Lok Sabha. And the Rajya Sabha has the power to amend or reject such financial bills like any other normal bill. Okay, so it is the sole discretion of the Rajya Sabha whether it will accept it, amend it, or reject it. Of course, such bills cannot be passed by either House of Parliament unless the President has recommended to that House the consideration thereof. But the rejection or the amendment, this sole power depends on the is given to the Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha, the leader of the house, apart from the chairman and the deputy chairman, leader of the house is another functionary who plays important role in the efficient and smooth conduct of the business in that house. The leader of the house in Rajya Sabha is normally the prime minister, which very obviously we do know. The leader of the Rajya Sabha is the prime minister. If he is its member or any minister who is a member of the house and is nominated by him to so function, his primary responsibility is to maintain coordination amongst all sections of the house for a harmonious and meaningful debate in the house. For this purpose, he remains in close contact not only with the government, but also with the opposition, individual ministers, and the presiding officer. So from this paragraph, you can understand the ultimate speaker or the leader of Rajya Sabha is the prime minister, who is the member of the Rajya Sabha. And he is also a member of the house and is nominated by that house for the functional area. What is his responsibility? To coordinate among all, to maintain and have a meaningful debate. So let's not consider the debate to go in a worse situation. Considering this, he is the responsible person, the government person or the government minister who will have close contact with all the leaders, the opposition leaders, individual ministers, presiding officer, and everybody. So the Rajya Sabha's ultimate leader is the prime minister, who is the presiding officer. He occupies, by he I mean the prime minister or the leader of the Rajya Sabha. He occupies the first seat in the chamber in first row at right the side of the chair so that he is easily available to the presiding officer for consultation. Under the rules, the leader of the house is consulted by the chairman in regard to the arrangement of government businesses in the house, allotment of days or allocation of time for discussion on the president's address, private members' business on any day other than Friday, discussing on no day yet named motions, short duration discussions and consideration and return of a money bill. So these are the sole powers of the person, that is the Rajya Sabha's leader, the prime minister, who will take the first row at the right side or the right chair to the presiding officer for consultation. And what matters, he can discuss on the president's address, private members' business, but on particular days except Friday, and discussion on no day yet named motion, short duration discussions, and we can consider and return a money bill on such days. Now, a special provision, he is also consulted by the chairman in the matter of adjournment or adjournment motions or otherwise of the house of the day in case of the death of an outstanding personality, national leader or international dignitary. In the era of coalition governments, his task has become more challenging. Definitely, you know what a coalition government is. So in such a kind of governance, his task becomes more challenging, where his decision along with the others will be taken into consideration. He ensures that all possible and reasonable facilities are made available to the house for a meaningful discussion on any matters that is brought before it. So he will, as per the governance, not determine or not reject any kind of decisions or discussions that can be taken. So he will consider and make available to the houses a meaningful discussion and therefore bring about it. So I will also talk about the LOP, that is the leader of opposition. Let's come to this. The office of the leader of the opposition is in a legislature is of great public importance because everyone is focused on the leader of opposition. Its importance emanates from the central role accorded to the opposition in a parliamentary democracy. The role of the leader of opposition, in fact, is more difficult as he has to criticize, find faults, and present alternative proposals, policies, discussions, and carry on with the debate with no power to implement them. He has thus to perform a special responsibility to Parliament and to the nation. This is a very important power and position in the Rajya Sabha, where The leader of opposition is present and his task is really very difficult because he has to criticize, find faults, prepare alternate suggestions, proposals and policies as to whatever the decisions are being taken, and also conduct or take active part in the debate. So this was all about the answer to the question. Let me give you a quick recap to the question. Just read out the question. The Rajya Sabha has certain special powers in the Lok Sabha that adds to its prestige. Comment. Yes, you should definitely agree to this, because firstly, talk about the special powers of the Rajya Sabha, that is in matters of union list, state list and concurrent list. Union list, the complete decision is taken by the center, whereas for the state, the decisions are taken by the state, and for the concurrent list, the decisions are taken by both joint. Then again, you can see Rajya Sabha passes a special resolution with its majority, that is 2/3 of the members present for the meeting, that if required, the decision is belonging to national interest, then only the decisions or the proclamations taken from the Rajya Sabha will be made considered as the matter is of national importance or national interest. So that is the sole power of the Rajya Sabha. Next, Rajya Sabha can pass a resolution along with its 2/3 members for the decisions that they are taking on the basis that is it is related to national interest and for all India services common to both the union and the state. In such a case, the state decisions will not be taken into consideration. Only the Rajya Sabha's decision will be considered. Next, coming to the constitution, that is the president, where he or she is empowered with the powers in case of emergency. As I told you, three types of emergency is there. And in such a case where there is national emergency, financial emergency or constitutional breakdown, in such a case, the president, who is a member of the Rajya Sabha, will only be the deciding power. However, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha will definitely amend to it, or will definitely review this and approve this. But in case where Lok Sabha is not present, that is if this emergency is declared in time of its dissolution, then the Lok Sabha will have to approve it within 30 days of its reconstitution. But again, in that particular period of time, the Rajya Sabha is the only house to approve it. Next, coming to financial matters. In financial matters, Rajya Sabha cannot raise a money bill or pass it. It can be only done by the Lok Sabha. But other matters of financial bills can be introduced in Rajya Sabha. There are, however, various financial bills where only the Rajya Sabha can amend it without any limitations on its powers. So, of course, these bills can definitely be passed by either of the House unless the President has recommended to the House to consider it thereof. Next, talking of the Leader of the House, as you know, the Leader of the House is the Prime Minister, who is a member of the Rajya Sabha. He is the sole deciding power, and his purpose is to remain in close contact with all the government officers, opposition leaders and individual ministers and the presiding officer. He occupies the first chamber in the first row, right to the side of the chair of the presiding officer, and discusses on various matters, including money bill. Next, the chairman, he is also consulted by the chairman for any matters regarding outstanding personalities, death, national leader or international dignitary. Next, coming to the leader of opposition, who is also a member of the Rajya Sabha, he is a very critical person who is playing a crucial role in this performance, where he has to criticize, find fault, give alternate policies and carry on with the debates, who's also a member of the Rajya Sabha. So you can understand this question is very important for your examinations. And since this is not a basic level question, you can refer to this entire video for any help, any suggestions you require. This is a completely framed answer which will help you fetch adequate marks. At least I can say you can, if you follow this video, you can fetch your entire marks, whatever the marks is given, 5 or 10, or whatever questions are appearing. If you follow this, all the points are clearly detailed and explanation is provided in this video. So I hope you're preparing for your examinations and you will find a benefit out of this video. So all the best for your examinations and career ahead. Stay tuned and thank you for patiently watching me out. Thank you.